Hello, everyone, and welcome to the HKBU Admissions Information Hub for the Department of Music. I am Professor John Winzenberg of the Hong Kong Baptist University Department of Music, and I'm going to give you a very brief introduction today of our department, our different programs at the bachelor level that we offer, as well as some information for the admissions process for the upcoming year. And so I'm going to take you through this PowerPoint that you have on the website, and you can also refer to a video that I will be providing for you later, which is also linked next to the web link that you've got for the PowerPoint. First of all, I would like to give you a brief introduction to the music programs at HKBU. We've got almost 450 students in our Department of Music now, and they are situated in both our undergraduate and our graduate programs. And as you can see here, we've got a large number of programs, and that number continues to grow even this year. We have, starting with at the top, we've got the Associate Degree in Music Studies, which is a two-year program. We also have our traditional BA in Music, which is a four-year program. And then we also have a BA in Music Studies, which is in fact a two-year program that serves as a top-up degree for the associate degree. And some of our students also will go from the associate degree into the BA in Music program as well. And then we're quite excited because we have a brand new program, the Bachelor of Music in Creative Industries, which has just begun this fall and is now in its second month. And that is going to offer a lot of new exciting opportunities for interested students as well. And I will describe that in just a little bit. We also have a few graduate programs, including our taught MA program in music, as well as our MPhil and PhD programs. Now today I'm going to focus mainly on our core four-year bachelor programs here. And so let me start by introducing our BA in Music program here. And you can see that for all of our undergraduate programs, we have a very wide scope of study. And this ranges from performance and music theory and composition, as well as electroacoustic music and music education, into music history and general musicianship, as well as Chinese music and world music, and even conducting. Our BA in Music program has several different emphases that focus on practical skills and intellectual knowledge, but also a strong focus on developing creativity in a number of ways and areas. And this is all under the umbrella of individual development, because it's so important for us to determine our own paths for our futures. In our program structure itself, you can see that we are divided into our core and concentration areas here. The core of our music program involves performance and history, as well as theory and musicianship. And these are areas that all of our students will cultivate together, especially as an individual group during the first year and a half. And then in the middle of the second year, our students will then divide into concentrations, which are four different areas of focused studies. And those concentrations will then determine the paths for the final 2.5 years. And those all will lead to various types of honors projects, which the students undertake during their final year of study here. And those are individual pursuits, which might include performance or research and writing, or a combination of both. We have four main concentrations in the BA program, and these include composition, performance, directed studies, which is a rather more generalized and flexible area for individual selection, as well as music education. Now, I would also like to tell you a little bit about our new BM program in Creative Industries. The Bachelor of Music in Creative Industries program offers professional training in both scoring and popular music performance for film and television, as well as video games and other visual media. Students in this program study and develop skills in scoring for film and television, video games, and visual media, as well as popular music performance, songwriting, and music technologies for media production. Now, this program offers comprehensive training to aspiring composers, vocalists, and instrumentalists for careers in the creative and in entertainment industries. Unlike our regular BA program, which has four concentrations, the new BM in Creative Industries program has two primary concentrations, one being scoring for film, television, and video games, and then the other track is in popular music performance and songwriting. All of our programs and all of our students get to benefit from our growing facilities and our updating facilities, and we have some even more exciting news about those facilities that you will see in just a moment. One of our areas of pride involves our keyboard instruments. Of course, like most of the major music departments around the world, we have a wide array of grand pianos and upright pianos, but we are especially proud of our historical piano and keyboard area, where we have forte pianos and harpsichords and organs, which allow our students to investigate and learn skills in older music forms, as well as contemporary approaches to those older forms. Of course, we also have lots of other instruments, and we've just named a few here, including harps, different types of drums, a huge and growing collection of percussion instruments as well. Our facilities also focus on technology, including the Electroacoustic Music Center and the Laboratory for Immersive Arts and Technology, or LIATE, which I will show you more about in just a second. And we also focus on our performance venues that we offer at HKBU. Our students benefit in the Hong Kong setting, both on campus and off campus. We perform regularly at our on-campus venues, and these include Academic Community Hall, our rehearsal hall on campus at the Ao Shu Hung Rehearsal Hall, as well as the Recital Hall, AST 916, which is a beautiful facility. We also have LT3, the YC Cheng Lecture Theater, where we have regular weekly events, and the University Chapel. But like I said, we also perform regularly off campus at some of the main Hong Kong venues, such as the Cultural Center and City Hall Concert Hall. Now, on campus in our high-tech music facilities, all of our students will participate and benefit from our Electroacoustic Music Center. And this is a professional standard three-room recording studio with state-of-the-art equipment and computer software. And all of our students take classes and become familiar with using this equipment so that they all gain a basic proficiency in recording and in editing technologies. We also have the state-of-the-art Laboratory for Immersive Arts and Technology, or LIATE. Now, this is a UGC-funded joint university facility for transdisciplinary research and creative projects in immersive 3D audio and multi-screen video. I know those are a lot of big words, but in a nutshell, this allows students to get access to new mediums and new forms of presenting performances that include video and audio technology using multiple screens, using surround sound of sorts, and the most advanced types of softwares. Now, this is a special slide that we have for you here. As you can see, we've got the layout for a new creative hub, and this is going to be at the Hostel and Academic Building Complex, which is just being built right now. In fact, they just started building this new building, and they expect the year of completion to be 2023, and that's coming very soon. So anyone who would be joining from next year would have a chance to benefit from this new building. Now, you can see, as is printed in the red here, that there's a video that accompanies this. And this can be found on the website that you see, which is right next to the link for your PowerPoint, which is this presentation right here. And I encourage you to take a look at the video, because it's going to give you an introduction to this beautiful new complex that's being planned and built. You can see a little bit about this now. On the top floors, that's going to be the new hostel complex, a new building or a housing complex for students. But the lower floors that even go underground are going to house the music department when we move there in 2023. And it's also going to house the different parts of the departments that form our creative media cluster. For example, the Academy of Film and Communications, the Creative Writing Department, could be the Academy of Visual Arts, and all of these different departments will interact to research and to try to create new forms of presentation, of entertainment, and of creative projects. Now, we currently have a number of performing ensembles at the music department, and we're very proud of these because these have helped strengthen the department and our profile in the Hong Kong community and even abroad. We've got several choruses, including the University Choir, the University Chamber Choir, the Cantoria, as well as the BU Women's Chorus. And then we've also got a couple of main orchestras, the BU Symphony Orchestra and the BU Chamber Orchestra, the Collegium Musicum Hong Kong, which play very high profile performances in Hong Kong and outside of Hong Kong. And we also have a string ensemble, as well as various other chamber music groups that you can see listed here, including percussion, horn ensemble, trumpet, saxophone ensemble, low brass, a good number of different ensembles that our students all benefit from. These ensembles and even individual students then get to participate in special performance opportunities. These could be sponsored by the department. For example, our annual gala concert, which is sponsored by the HKBU Symphony Orchestra, usually takes place at Hong Kong Cultural Center Concert Hall. And every year they will invite world famous guests to perform usually concerto types of concerts with the orchestra, as well as other major orchestral works. But on the right, you can also see some special projects where we might include multimedia. It could include dance and video and special new music. For example, this reimagined reflecting on human experience through sound and image. We've also been able to benefit from opportunities by participating in the Hong Kong Arts Festival. For example, the Cantoria performed as the main chorus with the Suppliant Women at the 46th Hong Kong Arts Festival, which was a staged production with the UK Actors Touring Company. And we have taken regular music tours with several of our instrumental and choral groups, including concerts at the National Center for Performing Arts in Beijing, performing on BBC Radio 3 in London, performing at Carnegie Hall in New York City, and taking a special study tour to Dunhuang on the Silk Road. Central Conservatory of Music in Beijing, and performing at King's College at Cambridge University in Cambridge, UK, in Prague and in Vienna, and also different places in Beijing, Czech Republic, and Tianjin. And two of our groups in 2018 went to Bangkok for special week-long recording projects at Studio 28 in Bangkok. And those CDs are just coming out now from that week-long project. So very exciting tours that continue to grow and be offered each year. Of course, with our students, they enter and they want to be thinking about their further career prospects and further possible studies after the degree programs here. And we've enjoyed great success in this respect. Our recent graduates have launched careers in education, in arts management, audio and visual production, and other music-related fields. And I want to emphasize this because the scope of possibilities for the careers after graduation continues to get bigger and bigger, and it usually depends on the student's individual interests and how they are able then to balance and mix their interests into kind of a professional portfolio that they put together. Other graduates have also continued their studies at graduate schools in Hong Kong, in the US, in Europe, and elsewhere around the world now. And so we've listed for you here just some of the most prominent schools that our graduates have furthered their studies at in the US, in the UK, and elsewhere. And this is only a partial list. The list continues to grow as our students become more and more engaged with different parts of the world. Now, of course, you'll be wanting to know about our admissions procedures. And so I want to give you an idea of what some of the minimum requirements are, both from the university and from the Department of Music. We are part of the Faculty of Arts at HKBU. However, the admissions track for the music department is separate for music from the other Faculty of Arts. And so please be sure that you understand that clearly. And for next year, I'll tell you a little bit about our JUPAS requirements here. Of course, you want to know about how you need to do on your DSAs and what you need to expect in order to put yourself in the best standing, in the best possible position. For JUPAS applicants, we now require 6 subjects to be taken and submitted. Those include the 2 main language subjects, English and Chinese, where the university requires level 3s. And then it requires level 2s in 2 other subjects, which are mathematics and liberal studies. And then we also require 2 more elective subjects, and those need to have level 3s in both of those subjects. In case you are interested in language, you can include other languages that are not English or Chinese, but that are listed at grade E or above as an unspecified elective subject. You can use those for your electives. I also want to tell you about the non-JUPAS requirements, because no doubt some of you might be interested in coming from other associate degree programs or transferring from other programs. And we do get a good number of students coming into our year 3 and year 1 each year for the BA programs. And so we've listed those out in 2 different boxes here for your reference. The top box is for those who wish to apply for year 3 entry. Eligibility for year 3 entry would be in non-JUPAS. Anyone who has an associate degree who's in the final year of your associate degree or higher diploma or professional diploma program. And you could also be a transfer student from another program, or you might also be a degree holder. And we get every one of those 3 types of students each year. So this is if you want to apply for year 3 entry. But even if you are part of that group of students, you could also consider applying for year 1 entry as well. And the advantage for that is, of course, that then you can fulfill more of the music courses that you might not have been able to take in your other programs. Now, the lower 2 boxes are for those who don't fit in to the upper boxes. And specifically, these would be students who are not final year students of the associate degree or transfer students or degree holders. And so there's a long list that we've got here. But of those, most of those that we get then would be associate degree holders, higher diploma, baccalaureate students. But you can see that there's the other list as well. And again, like I mentioned, if you are not a final year degree student from the other programs or a transfer student, then you would only be eligible for year 1 entry in the non-JUPAS track. However, I do want to emphasize that the university adopts a holistic approach in selecting applicants for interviews and exams on a case-by-case basis. And so I do want to encourage you to consider all these possibilities, JUPAS and non-JUPAS, at these different levels to find out which one might be better for you. Because our experience is that now, with this greater variety of tracks for entering the BA programs and the BM programs, students find the right path and the right way to enter the university. And it doesn't matter which track they come from, many of them from each track can become some of our top students and go on to very successful careers. Now, let me talk a little bit more about the minimum requirements on the music side, both for our BA and our Music in Creative Industries program. For the music requirements, we have 2 main requirements. First of all, we require a grade 8 in the ABRSM practical exam or its equivalent, and that equivalent is especially relevant for people who are studying Chinese instruments. But we will be open, in case you did not take the ABRSM track, to looking for equivalents at that level. And then on the theory side, we also require at least a grade 5 in ABRSM theory or its equivalent. And we would also encourage you to show some evidence of distinction in music. For example, if you had participated in festivals or competitions, or if you had portfolios of special performances or compositions, show us those things and show us any extra activities that you may have been involved in. And that will help us get to know you better and your profile so that we can try to imagine the possibilities for your advancement in the coming years. Now, the admissions procedure really gets started next spring. And so now is a good time for you to start your planning. As you can see here, first I'm going to talk about our BA program only, and then I'll talk about the BM program in just a minute. Our BA program, this includes a written exam after you submit your initial application, followed by audition interviews. These are not for everyone. We'll take it step by step, so that first you will submit your applications, and that is our first level of screening to ensure that you meet the minimum requirements for the university and for music. And then you may be invited to take a written exam, followed by the possibility of being invited for an audition interview, depending on how well you do on that written exam. So for the non-JUPA students, this process takes place between March and June of 2020. For the JUPA students, it takes place primarily in May and June of 2020. And as you can see here, the shortlisted applicants based on your initial application submission, so make sure that that is good and complete, may be invited to sit for a written exam for the BA only, and then possibly an audition and interview depending on how the exam goes. Now, the written exam itself will cover basic music theory and basic knowledge of Western music history. So I highly encourage you, before you take that exam, to do some review so that we can get a sense of your very best ability and knowledge level right now. Then, if you can meet the minimum standard from that exam, you may be invited to attend a 7-minute audition interview. And then you need to prepare a couple of pieces on your major instrument. And this interview and audition consists of two pieces in contrasting styles and historical areas on your major instrument or voice. Now think about that carefully, because you need to make sure that the style and the historical period are not the same for those, because of course we want to see your versatility. We want to know your basic abilities across the board. If by chance you have a second instrument, you may be invited to perform a short excerpt for a minute or a few minutes on that second instrument as well. And so if you have a strong second instrument, let us know, indicate it in your application, and bring it with you so that we can ask you to perform a little bit during the interview audition then as well. And we would also encourage you to submit supplemental materials, especially if you're interested in composition. For example, if you have a portfolio of even a few compositions or one or two compositions, it would be great if you could bring a copy of that. If it's been performed, give us a DVD or a CD of that and let us see what you have. And that will help us get to know you better and get to know your prospects better. Now, let me also talk about the Bachelor of Music program in Creative Industries here. It's a similar procedure, but it's a little bit different from the BA program. As well, for non-JUPA students, we will consider that during March to June of 2020. And then for JUPA, again, it's May to June 2020. Now here, the applicant's ability can be assessed by the criteria that we've laid out for you here. And this includes an interview audition and a portfolio, which is different from the BA process. And the portfolio could include compositions for scoring, as well as audition and video recording for performance. So we've broken these down into the two different areas here, but they are quite similar. For scoring for film, television, and video games, we would want to see a short video of performance of existing music that you have already, plus recordings of original composition. The performance portfolio should demonstrate performance, songwriting, and other creative ability. For For popular music performance and songwriting, it's quite similar. We ask that you provide a short video of your performance of existing music, plus recordings of any original compositions you might have. And that portfolio should also demonstrate performance in songwriting and other creative abilities. And then at that point, you may be invited to an audition interview based on your initial application submission. And the shortlisted applicants would be invited to sit for that audition interview, in which, again, you would need to prepare a 7-minute audition on your major instrument or voice. And again, that needs to consist of two pieces of contrasting styles and historical eras. And applicants who are proficient on a second instrument, again, may be invited to perform for a few minutes on that second instrument. So again, we want to see everything that you've got that might be relevant to help us monitor and assess the possibilities for your overall development in the coming years. Now, here's a special note. For those who are going to be applying to the BA and BM programs on the JUPAS side, only Band A JUPAS applicants and non-JUPAS applicants who meet our minimum university and departmental entry requirements may be invited to attend both the written exam and the audition interview, or the audition interview only. So this is to say that we want to make sure that if you're non-JUPAS, make sure that you meet our minimum departmental and university requirements. And if you're JUPAS, make sure you meet those minimum university and music requirements, but also list us as Band A. Be sure you do that. And then when we get to the time in the spring where we will invite the candidates for audition and interviews, we will do that by email. Emails will be sent from the university approximately 1 week prior to the exam and the audition interview. Now, this has just been a very broad, very quick introduction to the department and to our admissions process. And so I would highly urge you and encourage you to contact the music department as well as the university admissions office for further information. And you can see the email addresses here for the JUPAS and for non-JUPAS applicants, as well as our hotline that you can call for JUPAS and non-JUPAS inquiries. And of course, you can contact the Department of Music. And if you have an opportunity to come and see any of our concerts, or if you would like to come and observe any of our rehearsals or sit in on any of our classes, we would be happy to arrange something like that for you so that you can get a better idea of what our university life and our music life is in the Department of Music. So it's been a great pleasure for me to present to you today, and I will look forward to having a chance to meet all of you in the future, and I want to wish you the very best of luck and the best process for your discernment as you prepare for the coming university years. Thank you very much.